this is the Tinker Hanwei Hand and a Half, or Tinker Hanwei Bastard Sword, which we will be comparing today with the Ronin Katana Longsword. All right. Cut the cap off of it. That's cool. All right. We're ready? All right. Difference between this one and the other one, besides obviously the size and the weight, is this one can be used one-handed if you need to. That's why I took my Johnny Cash shirt off. Clearly, they both will stab. And
alright, boys and girls, probably mostly boys, here we have it. The review of the Ronin Forge Longsword number 7. It's European Longsword number 7. And we will also be looking at the Hanwei Tinker Bastard, or the Tinker Hand and a Half, at the same time as a point of comparison. I already have the Hanwei just recently on Traumatic's suggestion, purchased the Ronin, and oh my god, I am very impressed. So let's get some specs out of the way here. The Hanwei is 43 inches long overall. That's 110 centimeters for those of you outside the US and Liberia. It's made of 5160 high carbon, 33 inch or 84 centimeter long blade. It is got a leather wrapped handle, and the handle and pommel combo is about 8 3/4 or about 22 centimeters long. So that's the Hanwei. It costs, as soon as I get to the other screen here, $220.95 plus the $20 that you will want to add for sharpening. So it's a $240 item, and we're going to be comparing it with the, in my opinion, far, far, far superior Ronin Katana two-handed longsword number 7, which is only $10 more. So the Ronin longsword number 7 is 47 inches or 120 centimeters overall. Messed up my little scale here. And it is made from 1075 spring steel, has a 36 inch or 92 centimeter blade. It is cord and leather wrapped, and where the Hanwei has a nut, which in its own way is kind of cool because you can tighten it up and you can change out the hardware and change out the blade. You can change it out to a dull blade if you want to do sparring. I don't do any sparring. I just cut stuff in the backyard because I'm old and I don't really want to fight anybody anymore. The Ronin is peened, which is how they used to do it in the old days. Much more comfortable to get two hands on the Ronin than on the Hanwei. So I was told by Hammer of God that I would like everything about it but the frog. He is right. This frog is only going to be used as a pattern for when I make it out of actual leather. I'm gonna put a real belt on it, use the frog, this portion, and this portion only as a pattern. Same thing with this. Now this scabbard is actually pretty well made. It's got a metal chape, I think it's called. I'm not sure, but I'm very, very non-confident in the way that's said. But you can see down in there, it is, well, maybe you can see down there. It is a wood scabbard. It's covered in leather. The leather is stitched on there. If we can get a good view of that, there we go. Leather stitched on there. They did a decent job of everything except for these three bits of non-leather. I don't understand why they put leather on everything else, and this is some kind of faux leather. It's very aggravating. Don't know why they did that. Anyways, when it comes, even from, so when the hand wire came from Cult of Athena, I ordered it to be sharpened, came in ostensibly sharpened, and it was horrifyingly dull. The Ronin Katana showed up sharpened. Again, it was dull, but not nearly so dull as the Hanwai. So the Ronin and the Hanwai both are the reason, if you don't own one of these and you are into swords, you better go get you a work sharp. For my knives and shorter stuff and stuff I want to be super razor sharp, I've got some really high-end Hones. Dia sharp, as you can see right there. But for swords and machetes and choppers and anything with a big long blade, if you don't have one of these, you will very much wish that you had. All right, and of course, if you've got a big 2-inch wide belt grinder, you know, that's great. That's great too. Or belt sander, really. That's great too. But the work sharp, I cannot recommend enough. So these two have taken a ton of work. I'm actually going to do a little bit more work on them as well after I get done with this. And we'll do a little bit of cutting in the backyard and show y'all some pictures, show y'all some video of what it can do in action. But the short and skinny is this thing comes out of the box. Very impressive. It is a lot of swords. Actually, I'm not sure my arms are long enough to get everything in the picture here, but it is a lot of sword. It feels very substantial in your hand. It weighs about 3.5 pounds. And for the money, if you're looking for a European longsword to actually get out and cut with, I absolutely do not think you could do better than this one.
Yep.
Holy shit, I got a crew cut.
Holy shit, how about that?